Hello, my dear students. Today I'm going to talk about the type of concentration units. As you know, for solutions, to define the concentration of solutions, we need some units. And today I'm going to talk about that units. What are these units? These units are mass percentage, volume percentage, and important one, the molarity. Molarity is the most common concentration units. And after that, I'm going to talk a little bit about solubility. And today I have some examples, and I'm going to show these concentration calculations by using some examples. Okay, let's see one by one these concentration units. Okay, the first one, mass percent, or you can say mass percentage, or percentage by mass, or in here, you know, weight percent, you can use this name. Okay, what is the mass percent? Mass percent expresses the mass of a solute present in a given mass of solution. This means, for example, you have a solution. In this solution, you have 5 gram of solute and 20 gram of solvent. Okay, mass percentage means you have a 25 gram of solution and you have 5 gram of solute in this solution. Or what if your solution is 100%? Okay, if your solution is 100%, what is the mass of solute? Mass percentage defines this amount of solute by percentage. This means if you have 100 gram of solution, what is the mass of solute in the solution? Mass percentage gives the answer of this question. Okay, what is the mass percent? Okay, mass percent is mass of your solute over mass of your solution. In your solution, you have solute and solvent. Solute plus solvent, it forms the solution. So in here, in the numerator, you have mass of solute. In the denominator, you have mass of solution. Okay, mass of solute, mass of solution, multiple 100. Okay, now I have a solution and I'm going to show how we can use this mass percent formula. Okay, a solution is prepared by mixing 450 gram of water and 50 gram of sugar. What is the percent concentration of sugar by mass in this solution? Okay, in this solution we have solute and we have a solvent. Our solvent is water, which is 450 gram. Our solute is sugar, which is 50 gram. So percentage by mass is equal to, just a minute, I want to look at here, mass percent, percentage by mass. Okay, just a minute. Okay, percentage by mass is equal to mass of solute, which is 50 gram, over mass of solution, which is solute plus solvent. It is the solution. Okay, 50 gram plus 450 gram multiple 100. Use a parenthesis because it's useful, because you can mix these numbers. So use that parenthesis. Okay, so 50 gram over 500 gram multiple 100. That's it. So cancel out this 100 and the zeros of 500, it is equal to 10%. Okay, this is the percent by mass of this solution. That's it. Okay, let's continue. And I have another example about mass percentage. Glucose is the main substance in a solution used for intravenous feeding. Okay, how many grams of glucose must be dissolved in water to prepare 500 gram of 5% solution by mass? Okay, in here we have a solution which is 500 gram and 5% of this solution is glucose plus water. 500 gram solution, 500 gram solution, and it's 5%. This means if you have a solution with 100 gram, if you have 100 gram of solution, 5 gram of this solution is glucose, water, glucose. 5 gram is glucose. But you have 500 gram of solution In 500 grams of solution, how many grams of glucose that you have? In here, you can make a cross multiplication. X multiple 100, it is equal to 500 multiple 5. Cancel out this 100 and the zeros of 500. It is equal to, X is equal to 25 grams. This is one way. Okay, this is one way. Or you can simply find the 5% of 500. Okay, it's easy. You can find the 5% of 500. How you can find 500 multiple, it's the 5%, 5 over 100. So cancel out the zeros. Okay, it is equal to 25 grams. This is another way. Another way. If you find the 5% of this 500 gram, that's it. You can find the solution. Okay, now the volume percent. Volume percent is similar with mass percent. It's easy. Volume of solute over volume of solution. But in here, we don't use grams, not grams. This is the mass percentage. In here, just a minute. In here, we use volume. And the unit should be a volume unit. Like milliliter, like liter, like centimeter cube. That's it. A volume unit. Okay. Volume percent is similar to mass percent. It's generally preferred when working with solutions where all components are liquids. Maybe for some solutions, the components are liquids. For this reason, you should use, you can use the volume percent. In here, we have an example, antifreeze solution like ethylene glycol in water. Ethylene glycol in water, it's the antifreeze solution. And in the solution, you can use volume percent for your calculations. Okay. I have a question about this. Acetone is the main substance found nail polish removers. You know, the ladies love these nail polish removers. A solution is preferred by mixing 20 ml of acetone and 30 ml of isopropyl alcohol. Calculate the volume percent of acetone in the solution. Okay. What do we have here? Acetone and isopropyl alcohol. Isopropyl alcohol. Okay. 20 milliliter acetone, 30 milliliter isopropyl alcohol. Which one is solute, which one is solvent? The amount of isopropyl alcohol is high, so it's the solvent, and acetone is the solute. Okay. Volume percentage is equal to 20 milliliter over 20 plus 30 milliliter multiple 100. Use a parenthesis because you can mix the numbers. So it is equal to 20 over 50 multiple 100. If you can cancel out this 50 and 100, 100 becomes 2 here. It is equal to 40 percentage by volume. That's it. Now, the most important concentration unit, it's the molarity. Molarity is the most important concentration unit. Why? Because it's the most common, for this reason it is important, most common concentration unit, and we will need these concentration units to understand most of the concepts in chemistry. Okay. Molarity of a solution is the number of moles of solute per a liter of solution, and it is denoted by M. Okay. Molarity simply is mole number of solute, which is N. We use the symbol N here. And volume of solution. Okay, it's not the solute. The mole number of solute, but in here we use volume of solution, not solution. Solute plus solvent, the total volume. Okay, so molarity is equal to mole per volume. That's it. Molarity is equal to mole per volume if you use the symbols. Okay, I want to show again, I want to show my examples. Okay, I have an example here. You have 3.50 liters of a solution that contains, okay, we have a solution, the volume of our solution is equal to 3.50 liter. Nice. That contains, in this solution, we have sodium chloride. The mass of this sodium chloride is equal to 90 gram. Okay. And we have the molar mass of this sodium chloride. It is equal to 58.44 gram per mole. Okay. Molarity is equal to mole per volume. We have volume. We know the total volume. It is 3.50 liter. But we don't know the mole number. But with these informations, we can calculate the mole number. Mole number is equal to mass over molar mass. Remember this. Mass is equal to 90 over over 58.44. Okay, and it is equal to approximately, okay, I'm going to use a calculator. It is equal to 1.54, approximately 1.54 mole. Okay, now we can calculate the molarity. Molarity is equal to 1.54 mole over the volume 3.50 liter. Okay, it is approximately 0.44 molar. Okay, this is the molarity. That's it. Another example about molarity. What will be the new molarity? New molarity of 200 milliliter 6 molar sodium chloride solution if 600 milliliter of water is added to the solution at the same temperature. Okay, we have a solution. It is 200 milliliter and 6 molar. This is the molarity. Now, if we add 600 milliliter of water to this. Okay, this is our solution. And if we add 600 milliliter of water to this solution, the total volume will be 800 milliliter. Total volume or final volume, and it is equal to 0.8 liter. Okay, liter is important here because in molarity is equal to mole per volume. This, the unit of mole is mole, you know. The unit of volume is liter here. For molarity, you should use liter. Okay. Now, this is our new volume. But the what is our solute in this solution? Our solute is sodium chloride. The amount of sodium chloride is same because we don't add anything like sodium chloride. We add just water. So, our solute is sodium chloride. The amount of sodium chloride is stable. It's constant, okay? Why? Because we didn't add anything about sodium chloride. So, we can calculate the mole number of this sodium chloride. The sodium chloride, the mole number, it is equal to molarity is equal to mole per volume. Mole is equal to molarity multiple volume. You can find this by cross multiplication. One here, cross multiplication. Mole is equal to molarity multiple volume. Okay, let's calculate the mole number of this sodium chloride. But to calculate this mole number, we should use the volume at the beginning of this question. Okay, normally we have 200 milliliter of solution. In this solution, the molarity is 6 milliliter. The molarity is 6 milliliter. So, in here, molarity is equal to 6 multiple 0.2 liter. Because 200 milliliter is equal to 0.2 liter. If you convert the unit, 0.2 liter. Okay, so the mole number is 1.2 mole. Okay, this is the mole number of sodium chloride. We calculate this, the mole number of this sodium chloride by our solution, not our new solution. Okay, our new solution includes 600 milliliter more water. So, new molarity is equal to mole number 1.2 mole. It's stable, but the new volume is equal to 0.8 liter. So, if you make this calculation, molarity is equal to 1.5 molar. That's it. So, when we add 600 milliliter of water, this is the calculation of this solution. Okay, now we have another formula about molarity. This formula is similar with the other formula, but we use this formula when we are mixing two solutions. When we are mixing two solutions, final molarity multiple, final volume is equal to M1 V1, M2 V2. How many solutions that you have, you are going to write it MN VN. Okay, maybe if you have two solutions, if you mix two solutions, you should use this part of this formula. Okay, that part of this formula, because the mole number of the first solution plus mole number of the second solution is equal to mole number of the total solute. Maybe you can use it. I'm going to show this formula, how we can use this formula by an example. Okay, what is the molarity of a solution obtained by mixing 200 milliliter 0.3 molar ammonium nitrate solution with 400 milliliter 0.6 molar ammonium nitrate solution? We have two ammonium nitrate solution and we are mixing them. The first one, first solution, 200 milliliter 0.3 molar. Second solution, 400 milliliter 0.6 molar. Okay, in here M final V final is equal to M1 V1 plus M2 V2. Okay, that's it. Now first solution, and in this type of questions you can you don't have to change the the volume unit into liter. Why? Because if you use milliliter, that's okay, because you cancel out those milliliters. But if you use milliliter for one part of this formula, you should use that milliliter in all of the parts of this formula. Okay, look at here, 0.3 multiple 200 milliliter plus 0.6 multiple 400. Okay, now, and what is V final? V final is the total volume. 200 here, 400 here. Total volume, it's equal to 600 milliliter. But we don't know final molarity. Okay, look at here. 60 here plus 240 here, and it's 600 milliliter. Okay, it is equal to here 300 over 600. 300 comes from here and 600 comes from here. It is equal to 0.5 molar. That's it. Actually, you don't have to use this formula, but I think that if you use this formula, your calculations will be easier, but you don't have to use this formula. And finally, I'm going to talk about this solubility. Okay, let's look at the definition of this solubility. The solubility of a compound is the maximum amount of solute dissolves in a given amount of solvent to form a saturated solution at a temperature. Okay, solubility is related if we speak about solubility, your solution is a saturated solution, because the solution, the solubility means the maximum amount of solvent, that the maximum amount of solute that your solution can dissolve. Okay, so your solution is saturated in when we are talking about the concept solubility. Solubility data are generally reported in grams of solute per 100 gram of water. For example, the solubility of sodium chloride is 36 gram over 100 gram of water. This means 100 gram of water can dissolve maximum 36 gram of sodium chloride at this temperature. If the temperature changes, the solubility changes. Okay, if the maximum amount of a solute dissolved in 100 gram of water is less than 0.1 gram, this solute is said to be insoluble. If the amount of solute is below 0.1 gram, it's insoluble. It is between 0.1 and 1 gram, it's slightly soluble. If the amount is more than 1 gram, it is soluble. Okay, now I have two examples about how we can use the concept solubility. The solubility of potassium iodide is 136 gram over 100 gram. So this means potassium iodide, we have a solution, potassium iodide and water. The maximum amount of potassium iodide for in 100 gram, it is 136 gram. Okay. The question is, how many grams of water is needed to dissolve 204 gram of potassium iodide? If the potassium iodide is 204 gram, what is the amount of water that we need for solubility? Okay. Cross multiplication, you can find it easily. X multiple 136, it is equal to 204 multiple 100 gram. Okay. You can make this calculation in with classical methods, or you can use a calculator, but I'm going to cancel out these 136 and 204. If you divide 136 by 68, that's an important number for this question, 68. If you divide 136 by 68, it is equal to 2. 204, it is equal to 3. Okay. Now, 2x is equal to 300. X is equal to 150 gram. So we need 150 gram of water for this solution. Okay, now I have another question. The solubility of potassium iodide is 136 over 100 gram at 10 degrees. Same thing. How many grams of potassium iodide can be dissolved in 300 gram of water at 10 degrees Celsius? Okay, now I'm going to make it. Potassium iodide, water, same thing. 136 gram, 100 gram of water. You know this. Okay. Now, in this question, how many grams of potassium iodide can be dissolved in 300 grams of water? 300 grams of water that we have, but we don't know the amount of this potassium iodide. So, if we have 300 grams of water, how many grams of potassium iodide that we can dissolve in the solution? Again, cross multiplication. X multiple 100, it is equal to 136 over 300 gram. Okay, cancel out this 100 and 300. Okay, 3 here. And it is equal to 408 grams. Okay, that's it. This is another solubility calculation. Okay, now that's all about these concentration units about and we'll continue about the factors that affect the solubility later. That's all for today.